Most everything. And when you come to the fourth stanza, there a word console you can see. Console you have already seen in the glossary. Console is almost like an ambassador or a counselor who is acting for protecting the various needs of a person living in another country, for like an ambassador. So here the Jewish people, they should be protected by this consul when they are in a foreign country. So their duty is looking after these Jewish people. But when they came to renew their passport and when they came to present their issues, and now this counselor became very angry. So he banged on the table and then he is telling, if you have got no passport, if you have no passport, you are dead. So that shows an irony. The irony is a figure of speech that you can see, because the last line is telling, we are still alive, my dear, but we are still alive. So according to the speaker, actually the poet and his friend, they are already living, but they have no passport. So according to the consul, and they are actually alive, but as they have no passport, they are already dead. So that is an ironic situation. And the passport is the base for deciding whether these people are living or not. So that is contain an irony. And when you come to the next stanza, when do a committee, now both of them, they presented themselves in front of a committee, but they were also not having any sympathy or consideration towards these two. And now they are asking, you just come to the committee next year. And there is no hope at all. So they approached each person, but they have no hope. They became disappointed. And so the last line of that stanza also shows he is asking a question. Where shall we go today? As you have seen in the first stanza, they have no place to live in. So until the next year, where they will live? They have no place to live in. And in the, when we come to the next page, 155, in the next stanza, and now they were present in a public meeting. And when they were presenting there, and one of the speaker, he got up and said, and if we let them in, they will steal our daily bread. That means the people in this foreign country, they were afraid of these refugees. And according to them, if the refugees are continuously living in their country, and their bread or their food will be stolen by these refugees. So there is a misunderstanding in the mind of those people. They thought that these refugees are actually thieves. So that also disappointed our speaker. And so he was talking of you and me. So the speaker is telling, and who is stealing the bread? I and you. So they have no, the people in this country, they have no belief in this companion and the speaker. And so that is also a very desperate condition. When you come to the next stanza, there you have seen about what Adolf Hitler is saying. Already we have seen Hitler was trying to destroy the entire Jewish people from Germany. And so here the speaker imagines from a distance Hitler is talking, or he is commanding to the soldiers, they must die. Here they refer to the Jewish people. So he is giving commandment to his soldiers, wherever there is any Jewish people, they have to be killed on the spot. So here the Hitler's sound, the commanding sound is compared to the rumbling sound of a thunder. So that metaphor, you can see a metaphor, a comparison is there, that is Hitler's sound is compared to a thunder, rumbling of a thunder. And then towards the end of that stanza, the last line also says, according to the speaker, Hitler is talking about they, that they refer to I and you, that means the Jewish people. So wherever we are going, Hitler may find out us and we may be killed by his soldiers, by his Gestapo's. And when you come to the next